Has to get a new one. Carolina changing. Oilers take advantage. Here comes McDavid cutting from the net. McDavid scores! Connor McDavid! A new stick pays off right away with his 18th goal of the year, and we are tied at one. And once again, no more than two games without a point for number 97 in his young career.
This is why you go back to the bench. Check it out on the high wide. When you break your stick, this is why you go back to the bench. Don't play with that one. Just go get one. Stick breaks. He snaps it on his own. Gets one, standing there, waiting for it. Then he sneaks in behind on a bad change by the... Not really a bad change. A change there if the puck doesn't get deep. He breaks it on his own. He's mad, snaps it. He knows this is kind of ticked off. Give me my stick. Okay, now I'll take care of everything. Gets the new stick, as you call, partner. Fights off the check, defends the puck, protects the puck, builds the wall against Elias Lindholm. And what a terrific finish by Connor McDavid. And boy, the
puck comes over to Carrick. Shoots right across. That was intended for Brown. He's got it now. Works it back to the line. Gardner, a shot. That's knocked down. Lucid for Matthew scores. The velvet hands of Austin Matthews do it again.
Was a clinic, but it started with a great defensive play by Kadri on the two-on-one that was going to the net. And then it comes down the other end, and it's a clinic by the Toronto Maple Leafs and the Austin Matthews line. Not only do they get every on every puck first, every rebound they chase down, they win all the battles, and it's eventually Austin Matthews on the backhand. He's going to get some sloppy play as one player gets in the way of another. Matthews picks up the loose puck, and he just puts it straight upstairs on the backhand. It gives Mrazek no chance to adjust.
Weber will send it right back in again as he bumps into Malhotra. Pass deflects high in the air to center ice. Molson getting it back, steering it on, and the pass comes in over the line now to Ennis. Ennis trying to cut in front of the net, took the shot, rebound, he scores!
Tyler Ennis, seventh goal of the season, and it's a pretty one. And it was great effort all the way up through. The young man takes the puck, gets in behind the defenseman, takes it to the net, but keeps the whereabouts after falling, getting his stick on it, taking the backhand shot. Watch this. Most guys would have kept skating. He finds the puck and able to get that shot off. And I'll tell you, that was a difficult shot to get off, and he put it in the perfect position.
Well, the Sabres get on the board early.
In behind the goal. Kindle moved one to Ekblad. Through the middle. Miscue there. Off Barco. Oh. Scores! What a backhand top shelf by the captain. It's 1-0.
Well, Red Baron's going to be proud. Red used to have one of the best backhanders in the NHL, and Zetterberg has the same today. I don't know if that hit that Florida defenseman or not, but my gosh. Goaltender down again, top corner, right by his left ear. Turnover by Ekblad right there into the feet. And Zetterberg rifles a backhander into the top corner. His fourth goal of the year. And
Daniel Sedin. Blew a tire. Hall moves in over the Vancouver line. The drop pass to Everly. 5 seconds to go in the period. Everly towards the net. Backhander scores! What a shot! Top shelf with 3.1 seconds to go in the period. The Oilers are on the board.
Well, Daniel Sedin thought he was hooked down at the other end, and the Oilers start out after Daniel goes down. There's Daniel, thought he was hooked right there. Taylor Hall takes the puck. Gives it to Everly. You see Daniel looking at the referee, and this is a bad angle goal on the backhand. Everly takes a shot. I think he surprised Roberto Luongo, as Roberto doesn't get square. You can see how flat Roberto is. Look at that left shoulder. I talked about
the point of attack has been behind the net to quick passes to the front of the goal. He's made good stops.
Here's Solani with Ryan. Taylor to the backhand. He scores! As you said a couple of games ago, we haven't seen him go backhand this year. That was a pretty good looking backhand.
You may have just put the whammy on the youngster Kemper too, because boy, He probably hasn't seen a lot of guys like Tamas Solani in the Western League, because Solani, it's just so effortless the way he moves this puck from forehand to backhand. And he's just kind of coasting, but boy, it's a perfect shot. It's about a foot off the ice. Watch where this puck goes. A foot and a half off the ice, and it's just over top of the right leg.
Played on the far side, and Sharp rolls it across now for Kane. Kane across the line, crisscrosses, takes the drop pass, carries it through the backhand shot. He scores! Patrick Kane is only he can do.
Do this. Patrick Kane on the backhand from such a bad angle, controls the puck, keeps it, and scores from there. The only place you can score on a goaltender from that bad an angle, no matter how big they are, is that top corner right underneath the bar, and he hits all of the bars. I think it goes off the post, off the crossbar, off of everything, but it's in the back of the net. Incredible skill on the back.
Bozak got back to make a play. Now it's taken back by Jason Demers. For Fiddler, backhand.
Yes! Oh, my! From that angle on the backhand, Bert Fiddler has given the Stars a 2-1 lead.
Keeps poking at it, gets it back. Bozak gets on the right, wrong side of things for the Leafs defensively. And a mystifying, super soft and super mo. This one from the right wing side.
He can't score from there.
You can see the
lefty
eyes of Vern Fiddler. Elevates this. That is a perfect, I mean perfect backhand. Over the left shoulder. Chips.
Pressuring is Malkin. Oscar Klefbom comes to center. Malkin picks his pocket. In on Fane. The shot, he scores!
Well, sometimes you're just speechless. Bulls, he got him there. And then take a look at this. But that wasn't enough. Mesmerizing. What a play. What a spin-rama.
That's standing ovation material. And the fans are looking at it again on the big board here, Bob.
Well, you have to look at it again to appreciate it. There was way too
much. Here's a loose puck. Silver was trying to get there shorthanded. Bells back in front. Backhander scores! Silverberg shorthanded goal.
Oh my, you've got to love what happened here, and watch carefully as we show you how it all works. It was such a poor play by the Rangers in total. There's nobody back. Shorthanded situation. Not only is Silverberg there, but watch as the Sabres have got Alfredson coming in. That backhand, ladies and gentlemen, is one of the hardest things to do. You are 3 feet in front of the net, and that thing goes straight top shelf over the shoulder of Lundqvist.
What all the step. Lidstrom giving him the puck back. Datsu, backhander, oh, scores!
What a shot!
A beautiful goal by Pavel Datsu.
Right here, and he's going to go to the middle. Completely fake the defenseman right out of his jockstrap. And beat Halak over the catching glove with a bullet backhand. Oh my, look at that, Petrangelo. Oh, wow. What a goal by Kudiny.
And back in behind now for Pouliot. Kunitz hands it off to Crosby, coming with speed. Around Green. Crosby's backhander. Did that go in?
Yeah, I think it did.
Yes, it did. It went up underneath the crossbar. Crosby scores a beauty off the rush on a backhand shot to make it 1-0 Pittsburgh.
Well, he tried to dance Andy Green in the opening shift. He just danced the D of the Devils again and put a shot up under the bar. It was crazy. Green got beat this time by Crosby. He goes short side. As you can see, Snyder moving off the goalpost. Nobody's got a better backhand than that. And that is top shelf where you put the peanut butter. No mistake by Sidney Crosby. Just a beautiful effort after he just undressed Andy Green on the blue line.